Rage on that beat, going crazy.
As I predicted, the version of this painting done from life is much smaller than the version of the painting done from the photo. The reason this painting is smaller is because usually my paintings done from life are 1:1 or smaller. But, you know, that's not a problem. This basically means that it will take me less time to complete this painting, and this is evidenced by the way things went today. I was able to basically cover the canvas with one layer of paint in about 2 hours, maybe 2.5. And this excludes the time I took to pre-mix the paint. I always pre-mix the paint for the painting before I start. I just feel like it's more efficient that way. So I start mixing the paint the same way I start a painting or a drawing, which is from the inside out. So I started by focusing on the nose, and so what I noticed right away is that the information within the nose is very different from the information on the photo in that area. This was not a surprise to me. I was totally aware of that, and I mentioned this in a few times in the previous parts. But the thing that surprised me is the amount of information that the camera leaves out of the photo. The amount is significant. And if I were to come up with a number, it might be like 20-25%, but this is not a scientific estimate. It's just me making things up. I'm not sure if there's a way to quantify it, but maybe there is. Right now, all I know is that there's a lot of information missing. Also, one other thing I was wondering for just a minute was maybe the reason the information is missing from the photo is because of the photo quality. But, you know, the cameras that I take pictures with are pretty good quality. I don't think the resolution is the problem here. I totally understand that there are different settings on the cameras and things matter when not set properly, but I really doubt that the missing information is due to some insufficient picture quality in this case. If you're a photographer, let me know if I'm wrong. So overall, the actual palette for this painting is very different. I did record the paint mixing process for this version of the painting and the version of the painting done from the photo, and I'm going to do a separate video showing the two side by side so you can see how different the two color palettes are when put next to each other. But I can already tell that this painting is going to be lighter in contrast for sure. And the color range that I'm going to be using is going to be more detailed. Things are never perfect at this stage. There's a lot for me to adjust, but this is a good plan for the next few days. And what I've learned recently about my own painting process is that it takes me about 3 layers of paint to finish a painting. And so I think the same will be true for this painting, but overall I'm pleased with how things are going, and I'm planning to make a lot of progress tomorrow. So let's keep going.
Rage on that beat, going crazy.
We'll be right back.
Rage on that beat, going crazy.
So this is day three, and I didn't do a diary yesterday because I couldn't paint yesterday. So today I really wanted to catch up on the lost time, and I did make a lot of progress. Previously I mentioned that I might be able to finish this painting quicker because it's smaller, but today I learned that it's going to be the opposite. It actually is going to take me longer to finish this painting because of that same reason. When I get to the details, that's the part that takes a little bit longer because of the smaller size. Today, I actually regretted not setting up my easel a little bit closer to the thing. Being closer to the thing would allow me to see the details a little bit better, and things like the teeth or the inside of the nose would appear a little bit larger in my eyes, and it would have been a little bit easier for me to put that detail onto the canvas. Whatever, it is what it is. I didn't really want to go back and reverse what I was doing or restart the painting. I usually don't do that. I decided to keep going with the current size. And so when I was trying to do the detail, such as the teeth, this is where things got a little bit complicated because my obsession with detail kicked in, and I was trying to render the teeth aggressively with a brush that was too big for that type of detail. And whenever I use a brush that's too big for the detail I'm trying to render, that's when the frustration starts. So I decided to switch to a smaller brush, and the brush that I switched is this. And so this brush allowed me to render a lot of fine detail in between the teeth and on the surface of the teeth. There are quite a few very tiny highlights that I really did not want to lose, so I found this very helpful. So I did spend a lot of time on the teeth, and I think that showed on the time lapse. At some point I was like going back and forth, and then as soon as I switched to the smaller brush, or thinner brush I should say, things progressed much smoother. But after today, I feel like I'm going in the right direction, and so I'm not as worried as I was when I actually started this painting earlier today. While working on the background, I discovered a nice mix for this part. So at some point, I'm not sure if you recall, but I was planning to use cadmium orange to cover this side of the background. But when I started testing it, cadmium orange for some reason was not working out, so I had to look for alternative mixes. And what I discovered was that Indian yellow with a little bit of white works really well, and this color now matches the thing that I see. I also modified the color of the box on the top and on the side. And also, not sure if you recall, but when I was doing this from the photo, I used pretty much raw amber with a little bit of yellow ochre and I think a little bit of red. But the end result was that the shadow was dull and pretty flat. But in reality, this shadow, and again, I mentioned this before, is this really beautiful, rich, juicy olive color. And I came pretty close with the mix that I used for this. I also worked on this wall here, but I'm planning on doing at least two more layers of paint on here. There is this really intense rainbow of color. I really want to play around with it and see how close I can get to the real thing. So overall, I know I mentioned this, but you can already see how much different this painting is from the painting I've done from the photo. The way I'm reading the colors from real life is obviously very different, and so that's why this translation looks the way it does. So as you already know, I'm really excited to put these two versions of paintings together and compare them side by side. So let's just keep going. Rage on that beat, going crazy. No idea what day it is because I totally lost track of days, but I can tell you that I took a break from this painting. I left it to dry over the weekend because the paint wasn't sticking anymore at some point last week, and also I realized that I started losing interest in this painting last week. As interesting as painting is to me, painting the same thing twice is not as much fun. And so for this project, I chose to paint this twice, obviously. So the fact that I've been looking at the same thing for so long, it kind of just became a little bit boring at some point last week. I was also overwhelmed by how much work I still had ahead of me last week when I looked at this painting. There were some serious issues that I didn't think I could overcome, but I was able to get over all of that yesterday when I came back to this painting. I decided to start fresh and remix all the paint because I needed to clean up quite a few things on here. And so yesterday I focused on the skull. You can tell from this painting that the contrast between this side and this side is not that significant, but the contrast is still there. And so this is one of the challenging scenarios. So yesterday I paid special attention to this side and I was able to fix quite a few issues. And I also at the same time worked on this side because there are certain highlights on this side that make a big difference and make this side look brighter. Going back to my comment, the contrast is not as significant, but it's still there. So I did want to preserve that on the painting. One of the things I was really looking forward to working on are all these edges here around the skull and how they interact with the background. And depending on the area of the skull that I looked at, the edges are very different. So for example, this shape on this side of the skull, when it meets the background, the edge basically dissolves. It's there, but it's very soft. In contrast, the edge between this part of the skull and the corner in the background is much sharper. And, you know, there are many reasons for that. Basically, all around the skull, the edges interact very differently with the background. Another interesting area that I looked forward to working was this back of the wall. And I can tell you that when I looked at this on the photo, when I was doing the painting from the photo, I really couldn't tell what is going on in this area. So what I saw in the photo in this section is basically like a rainbow of colors without definition. So it was hard for me to tell what is it that I'm supposed to be painting. But in real life, what I noticed and what I realized is that each of these areas represents something. So for example, this right here is the shadow or a reflection coming from the skull. So the light comes through the filter, it hits the skull, and then there's a shadow hitting the back wall. This shape, that's a reflection of the box. And this area right here is basically the result of the light coming through the filter and hitting the wall. So all this information was missing from the photograph, and I wasn't really sure what I was supposed to be painting, like I mentioned. But here, when things became clearer, I was able to mix the paint better because I had a better understanding of what's going on. And the only thing I think need to correct is this edge right here, because I think it's too sharp. I need to soften it up. So this type of scenarios here is what I look forward to the most. I feel like this is where the illusion of three-dimensionality begins in a painting. And if things like that are not handled properly, then the effect of 3D is either eliminated or significantly impacted. So when I get to areas like this in a painting, I always try to give it special attention. Painting from life is difficult as it is. Scenarios like this make it that much more difficult. If your goal is to get some kind of a 3D effect, so painting from life is like a test, at least for me, because it reveals all the gaps I have in understanding what I'm looking at sometimes and how to handle what I'm looking at. The learning process never ends here. Anyway, let's just proceed with this painting. I think what I'll need is two more sessions at most to finish this. So let's keep going.